MBT, or main battle tank, is the core of any Army's armored force. They've played their part starting from World War I and are expected to have a significant role in the foreseeable future. U.S. Army's main battle tank, M1A2 Abrams, will receive notable upgrades in its latest variant named M1A2C. M1A2C was initially known as the M1A2 SEP V3. On the 16th of December 2015, the U.S. Army awarded General Dynamics a $92.2 million contract to upgrade M1A2 SEP V2 Abrams tank to the M1A2 SEP V3. Abrams has seen many upgrades, and this will most possibly be the last or penultimate one until a replacement is deployed, which is expected towards the end of next decade. The upgrade is aimed at keeping the tank one step ahead of the emerging threats and will enable it to serve through the 2020s. Production for the M1A2 SEP V3 is being conducted at JSMC in Lima, Ohio, and at the Anniston Army Depot in Anniston, Alabama. The U.S. Army accepted the first of about six initial production versions of the M1A2 SEP V3 Abrams back in October 2017. U.S. Army Lieutenant Colonel Justin Schell, then the Abrams product manager, had said at the rollout, "This version is the most modernized configuration of the Abrams tank. Having improved force protection and system survivability enhancements and increased lethality over the M1A1 and previous M1A2 variants. The Abrams M1A2 SEP V3 tank will be the foundation for future incremental system upgrades and can host any mature technology the Army deems operationally relevant." The first of these upgraded tanks is set to enter the service this year itself. Hank Kennedy, a manager at General Dynamics Tank Plant in Lima, Ohio, told Lima News, "We're in the throes of getting that together." Mr. Kennedy added, "The 1st Brigade is critical because we need to get them into the soldiers' hands so they can get trained on it and everything else." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the latest Abrams M1A2C variant. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium account. Abrams was first introduced in 1980 to replace the M60 main battle tank, which was introduced in 1960. It was significantly more potent than the M60 and featured many top-of-the-line components, like a fire control system that allowed up to 90% accuracy at ranges of 2,000 meters. The tank was technologically well ahead of most other tanks of its era. U.S. military has kept on upgrading the tank to maintain its edge. For example, in 1986, the tank received a more powerful 120mm German-engineered main gun. And in 1988, it got a layer of depleted uranium armor to increase protection. These upgrades were provided to Abrams so it could dominate the Soviet tanks and repeal any armored thrust. This helped Abrams tanks roll over enemy tanks in Afghanistan and Iraq. With the end of the Cold War, the chance of a large-scale tank fight in open battlefield diminished. But new challenges emerged. This mainly was guerrilla warfare and operating in constrained city spaces. For this, a remote-controlled 50-caliber machine gun and explosive reactive armor were added, apart from the inclusion of a telephone for the tank crew to communicate with nearby infantry forces. After the dwindling down of hostilities and slow reduction of U.S. involvement in Afghanistan and Iraq, a new challenge has appeared. This is the more assertive Russia, with which U.S. and NATO relation has steadily declined. Russian forces have basically annexed Crimea and have intervened in eastern Ukraine. So in coming days, a full-scale armored conflict can't be ruled out, similar to the proposition during the Cold War era. Hence, the M1A2C upgrade is focused to meet the changing dynamics of the situation. As relations with Russia deteriorate, the Abrams is once again America's most important weapon in a ground conflict in Europe. Abrams was designed so that it could accommodate new enhancements. This kind of forward thinking has enabled it to absorb new technologies. The Abrams M1A2C has added several features. Here's a brief overview. 1. It now includes an ammunition data link. With this, the tank crew can set a distance at which a shell will explode. So if a building is targeted, then the shell will explode inside the building instead of exploding after it's flown through it. This will enhance the precision of the hit. Destruction will be inflicted at the correct place and limit unintended damage. 2. M1A2C will see the addition of better infrared sights. Infrared sights basically enhance the night fighting ability, and with this improvement, the new variant will be better equipped for twilight missions. 3. The remotely operated 50 caliber machine gun will now be positioned in a comparatively lower height, enabling better targeting position. 4. M1A2C will have an auxiliary power unit, APU. This will allow the tank to keep running communications and sensors and maintain battlefield awareness without having to use its powerful 1500 horsepower gas turbine engine. The engine is known to use a lot of fuel and is also a target for infrared homing weapons. 5. It also adds passive armor, which will improve the tank's ability to survive when hit with the latest anti-tank weapons. 6. New Explosive Reactive Armor, ERA, packages, known as the Abrams Reactive Armor Tile, ARAT, will be deployed. ERA basically works by placing tiles that have explosives. These tiles are fitted on specific portions of a tank. When an incoming projectile hits them, they explode outward. This basically means that explosive power of the projectile is deflected, and this prevents it from penetrating inside the vehicle. 7. A better gun, which will have a longer barrel variant of the tank's existing 120mm or a larger caliber, will be present. But the exact specifications are not disclosed. 8. The most important upgrade will certainly be the addition of the Trophy Active Protection System, APS. Israeli-made Trophy will be fitted on the side of M1A2C. Active or hard kill protection systems consist of sensors that are capable of detecting and tracking incoming anti-tank projectiles. After that, the targeted tank launches an interceptor projectile to shoot the incoming round. This is different from soft kill approach, which involves jamming the projectile's guidance or confusing them. It's to be noted that U.S. Army has been experimenting with Trophy on the Abrams for some years now. In 2017, Colonel Glenn Dean, a project manager at the Army's Redstone Arsenal, had told Military.com that he tried to kill the Abrams tank 48 times and failed. The Trophy weighs around 1,807 pounds. Viewers may note that in 2018, the Army announced plans to purchase 261 Trophy sets. Russia's latest T-14 tank also has hard kill defense called the Afghanid. Abrams tank currently ranks among the top three tanks in the world. The upgrades will keep it that way for the next decade, too. The most likely rival of Abrams will be Russian T-72 and T-90 series tanks. Though potent, a reasonably new Abrams tank is more than capable of dealing with these tanks. Russia's next generation T-14 Armada tank, unveiled in 2015, will be a major challenge to even the most latest variant of Abrams. But the production of these is way behind schedule due to technical challenges, as well as a financial headwind. Russia has initially stated that it will acquire 2,300 T-14s by 2020. but it currently only has 20 of these, and is unlikely that it will be able to deploy them in said number even by 2030. In this situation, the upgraded program makes sense, as it's relatively risk-free undertaking and cost-effective too. The U.S. Army expected to send the M1A2C equipped brigade to Europe, as it's the most probable flashpoint. This will surely have deterrence effect, and Russian ground forces will think twice before trying to take on American-backed armored units.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.